What is up? It's Mikey, and we got some tips here for all the new people that are getting on to the Infinite Warfare beta for the first time this weekend. Let's just get into it. First thing, even if you decide not to play that day, just log in so you can get your salvage bonus. And speaking of the salvage bonus, what is that? So we head over to the quartermaster, right where the armory is, and it seems that in about a weekend, you can go to the prototype lab and you can try to make your way and get an epic weapon. Now, in my case, I made the mistake of trying to use the wreck, trying to get the epic wreck. A lot of people have not liked that weapon, but it is what it is. You can go for the Envy Flatline. I heard people say good things about that weapon, or you and a friend can split it up. Maybe one friend goes for one weapon and you go for the other, because it seems to take about a weekend to work up enough salvage points to be able to unlock an epic weapon. Okay, so maybe that way one friend could have one, he can die on purpose and you can test it out, and vice versa. Just an idea, just putting that out there. That is where you use the salvage points in the prototype lab. All right, so while we're here in the prototype lab, let's back up a little bit and go to the mission team depot. All right, so you got to pick a team that's part of the very beginning. They kind of tell you about that. There's two teams that you can play with, the Wolverines or the Orion Initiative. Don't switch these up. Stick with one of them so that way you can unlock all the stuff there is. All right, you make your way through the Wolverines and you will get the Havoc. You've seen me make some gameplays with this thing. It's really good. I'm sure you've seen other people gameplays. It's the one that allows you to get a nuclear. The Windfall is okay. It's all right. I made a gameplay with that weapon also. So sticking with the Wolverines, making progress with those guys, you will get some good weapons, that epic Windfall. That's just my opinion. Or you can stick with Orion and you can make your way through that. But either way, I probably wouldn't switch back and forth. Just stick with one of them. And a big little tip, if that makes sense, is when you're working with the team, you notice I'm gonna hit R1 and L1 here. See that little thing moving? You can flip through three of them. They really didn't mention this at all, but this is your active mission, meaning it's active. You're the one that's making it active. It's not very intuitive the way that they get this across, but this is what you're working on, okay? Earn a double kill. That is what you're working on. You're not working on earn one kill or the striker payload. Whatever it is that you highlight, you are working on that, okay? And speaking of which, once you complete that, it will update in-game. And I do think it's pretty cool that while you're in-game, you can hit start and it does show you whatever task it is that you're working on. So just keep that in mind to keep an eye on your task, because that is how you rank up, get XP, get your salvage. Now, speaking of create a class, play with all the things, use all the stuff, have fun. But if you are looking to get a lot of kills, that suppressor, the suppressors really won't hinder you as much as you think they would, especially with SMGs or if you're a close range type player. Please use the suppressor. It won't hurt you. They're great. They're fun. The must-have perk, at least in this beta, is Ghost. I don't always use Ghost in previous Call of Duties, but right here, because everyone has the default UAV unlocked, there's just so much spam, and then people are gonna run recon like I do, because recon is so good, because it gives you a UAV, gives you two swipes when the enemy first gets a UAV and then when it dies. That's a lot of recon floating all over the place. And so Ghost really is a good perk if you want to stay alive. Same thing with the suppressor. And while we're talking about the weapons, just stay away from these shotguns. I don't know, at least these three that are in the default unlockable right now, they're no good. They're really bad. I've taken the time to level them up all the way, unlock all the things. So take it from me, it's really not worth it, probably not worth your game time. Now, I also want to talk about the options. You can change all kinds of stuff. You can disable vibration, the sprint cancels, reload thing, you mess with that. But safe area, and I touched on this in a previous video, but basically, I like to have the safe area as far in as I can, so that way the mini map is as close to the center of my screen as possible. And you'll find, it may take, you know, a game or two to get used to, but you'll find that your eyeballs won't have to move as much. Okay, that's gonna be right there. You just have to glance up at it. You know, it's like driving a car. You got that rearview mirror right there. You wouldn't want the rearview mirror, you know, off to the side somewhere. You want it right there, right above you in the middle. Well, the same thing applies to Call of Duty. You want that mini map, easy to see. You can just glance at it, glance back, because this game, it is fast paced, at least with these small maps that they've given us, and just the gameplay in general. The audio options, for the first time ever, Infinity Ward has given you the option to take down the music. And if you're looking to hear some boosting or sliding, reloading, whatever, you could disable that music. I have, it's just been a habit. But a lot of people, myself included, have disabled the motion blur. It just clears things up a little bit. So those are some settings. Definitely mess with all these things. Now let's talk about the play style. You know, I was watching some other YouTubers, and a lot of people have come to terms with dying a lot. Marka J, I'm sure a lot of you guys watch his videos. He was saying in a video, yeah, I think I've just got to come to terms with dying 20 times. And this is Marka J, the guy that drops nukes in every game. And he's talking about dying 20 times. What does that mean? I'm gonna die 40 times? Well, I'm not exactly dying 40 times in a game, but I've had to change my play style drastically. And a little rule of thumb is avoid the middle of the map. Any map, any of these default maps that they're letting us play with. You can go in there if you're not on a streak, and you will definitely find some action. You can get 1-2 kills. And my rule of thumb is, if I can get 2 kills in the middle of the map, I'm out of there. Peace out. 3 kills, amazing. I get out of there, because you just have a high percentage of being shot in the back in this game. That is going to change your play style. It's changed mine, and now I run a circle around the map, either clockwise, counterclockwise, it doesn't matter. Pick a pattern that works best for you. You can go back and forth. You don't have to go in a circle if you don't want to, but you just gotta avoid that middle of the map. It's like we're back to Call of Duty Ghosts in a way, where you just don't want to get shot in the back, because it's so hard to turn on people. Maybe they'll fix the net code, I don't know, but you're gonna learn real quick that that's kind of the way that you need to avoid being shot on the back. Just going in a circle, and you gotta, you know, have that silencer and that ghost. You just gotta play so much more stealthy. What needs to happen? Do they need to bump up the health? Is it their internet code? I'm not exactly sure what it is, but I do know it's way faster to die in this game, and it has curbed me, where now I gotta be extra cautious. I was always a cautious player, but now it's made me extra cautious. So those are just some basic tips for you guys. I have found that yes, you do need a good weapon. You know, like in the case of the Windfall, it does add a little extra health every time you kill somebody. It's barely anything, but it helps you, because it takes so long to heal. You know, there's just so much stuff going against you. And once you've got a feel for things, got your whole setup, you will start to have more fun. Because I'll admit, I did not have fun at the very beginning there. So I am by no means a master at this game. I'm still learning things, just like you guys, leveling things up. If there's specific tips you want on this game, please leave a comment below. Take 3 seconds, rate the video, and I will see you guys next time. All right, so on the top there, we have more Infinite Warfare. You can click on the screen, links down below. And on the bottom, we have Call of Duty Clips of the Week. Guys, I need Infinite Warfare clips. So you got quads, triples, funny moments, anything cool, you can read down in the description how to send in your Infinite Warfare clips.